Today's reading is March Hare, an entry from the Monsco Encyclopedia book series. A variety of beastmen unique to Vunderland, the progenitor of this race was a were-rabbit who, so that she could live more comfortably, was granted the power of a mighty succubus by the Queen of Hearts, who absolutely adores rabbits. They're in heat all throughout the year, and they're sex-crazed. They're so lustful that sex isn't just on their minds, it is said to pervade their flesh, from the tops of their ears to the tips of their toes. When they come face to face with a human man, they often misinterpret his words in a lewd direction, perhaps because their heads become so filled with the desire for sex with the man before their very eyes, and wild fantasies. For example, if a man offered sweets by them responds with, "I want some," "I'll have some," or "sure looks delicious," or some variation of those words, they'll misunderstand it as, "I want some of you. I'll have some," in a sexual meaning, "your body sure looks delicious," and other more creative reinterpretations. In this way, after striking up a conversation with them, no matter how far removed the subject is from sex, they'll get hot and bothered, and the conversation will ultimately arrive at obscenity. And then, mistakenly believing that the man always wanted to have sex with him, they'll joyfully attack to initiate sex. When one begins having a conversation with them, at first it's confusing and impossible to understand, but while having verbal and physical exchanges and being exposed to their demonic energy and madness, one gradually becomes able to understand their peculiar thoughts and distortions of topics. Ultimately, a man will become sex-crazed like them, and will be able to calmly have an insane conversation that can be obscenely distorted from any given topic, and it will all seem strangely normal. Once they obtain a husband in this manner, their heads become full of thoughts of sex with their husband instead of the vague sex with men. Since the conversations ultimately always go back to the topic of sex every day, it naturally leads to spending their days having sex. For that reason, those who become their husbands will end up spending most of their days having lewd exchanges, verbal and physical. From the tops of their rabbit ears to the tips of their toes, the hare's body will be crazy for their husband. And once a man gets a taste of it, it's very easy to make him become sex-crazed, or rather, wife-crazed? I think that was supposed to be a pun in Japanese, but in English it kind of falls flat. Their dietary habits are just like the original species. They're herbivores and prefer vegetables, etc., but out of that they prefer demon realm produce, especially stuff with a high aphrodisiac effect. Instead of drinking water, they drink a sort of aphrodisiac. Their dietary habits further accelerate their sex drive, but it is said that they're constantly in heat to begin with, so it probably only makes a slight difference to them. Also, they often participate in tea parties held by monsters called hatters. One should be wary because the tea and sweets they offer are typically made, particularly from, demon realm produce with the same radical effects.